everybody, welcome to the channel and welcome to yet another episode of this mega ride from Bangalore to Ladakh. So this episode will take us from Delhi to Patnitop. Like I said in my previous episodes that, you know, we were pathetically late in reaching Delhi, more so because, you know, we were very much falling sick on the way, and we had to stop here and there, and we took a lot of breaks, so that contributed to this, you know, massive delay in the plan. So as per the itinerary, we were supposed to leave Delhi for Patnitop the very next day. However, keeping in mind the health of the team, and you know, we didn't get enough rest on that day, so we decided that we would be halting one more day. So why we took this decision? So our trip didn't get extended. So by the time we reached Delhi, so there was confirmed news that this time we were not going to cover Umlingla. Why? Because the authorities have, you know, are not giving permits until Hanle. And if you can't go to Hanle, so Umlingla is out of question. So that there, you know, we save 2 days. So what we decided was that let's not stretch ourselves. And since we already have 2 days of buffer time and we didn't want to end the trip early as well, so we decided that, you know, we should stay in Delhi and take a break, get our bikes checked, meet our brothers from Delhi chapter. And that's exactly what we did. So we had a gala time with the Delhi chapter folks last night, and we had a dinner together as well. And today what we decided, we will leave early morning and we will try to reach Patnitop as soon as possible. So we don't have our hotels booked in Patnitop, and that was the plan. We will not book the hotels in advance. So let's see how it goes. Keep watching, like, share and subscribe to the channel for more. Bye bye. Aim to reach Patnitop by evening. It was important that we had an early morning start to avoid the rush hour in Delhi. Delhi is known for its traffic during peak hours, and we wanted to avoid that. And so exactly we did the same. It's about 6 o'clock in the morning when we started up from our hotel, slowly navigating through these narrow lanes of old Delhi and make our way towards the highway. This area, by the way, is the Karol Bagh area, and to many of you who doesn't know Karol Bagh, it is famous for bike accessories and other stuffs that you can get fitted in your bike. So anybody who is planning to do the Ladakh trip and planning to stay in Delhi, probably this would be a better place as it has a lot of food options and people are very good. We stayed in a hotel called Hotel City Continental. The rooms were pretty much affordable, given the area and the locality, and we had no problems whatsoever. The room service was also okay, and we had a pretty wonderful sleep, and right now we are energized and as fresh as day one. Navigating through any metropolitan city during this hour, that means the early morning hour, is always a charm, and any city would offer you this kind of scenic, or I would say rather empty roads on which it is a charm to ride on. Delhi was none exception. So this is a very, very busy city, and given the capital of India, the security levels in this area was also equally high. However, it was just another city for us, and it was a stopover. It was important that we negotiate the traffic and move on and cross Murthal as early as possible. After Murthal, we would be entering Haryana, and from there, it's a straight road until Jammu and Kashmir border. It was important that before the peak hours, we cross the city of Delhi to move on to Murthal. That's exactly what we did. So keep watching this video. I hope I would be able to do justice by showing you bits and pieces of Delhi. And I will catch you up ahead when we stop for a proper break. Bye-bye. Friends, right now we have almost exited Delhi and will be exiting completely in about next 2 to 3 minutes. So, having crossed the city of Delhi before the peak hours was a satisfaction to the team. And we thought that, you know, everything would fall as per our plan. Seldom we realized that whatever lay ahead of us was equally horrifying. As the twilight of the dawn slowly faded away and was replaced with a bright sunny day, we only realized that the mounting temperatures are going to take a heavy toll on us. However, the team determination at this point of time was very good and we steadily progressed towards the end onto our destination. Delhi treated us very well and you would remember this for a very long time. This city is exceptionally beautiful in terms of the roads. Although there are very few bad patches here and there, but that's kind of magic. As we move ahead slowly, it was time that we stop for a small breakfast break. However, this highway happens to be fenced in, so we needed to cross Murthal. So I would catch you up ahead in Murthal, where we stop for breakfast. We record. However, what we decided is that, you know, we won't waste much time in Delhi. So if I record anything, I would definitely give an update on where we are. Else, where we stop for a proper break, we'll catch you. Keep watching and enjoy this drive with this music.
are right now nearing about Amritsar, and something went into Dipan's eyes, and we are doing first aid. So the roads are good. The road earlier was very good. Now it is a bit boring highway, plain, flat. The heat is building up right now. Dipan is suffering like hell. Bhai, tor helmet pora sathe ki kore poka dhuke gelo bhai?
Pani ekta
okay. And sand particle has got inside. Kolboda. Kolboda. Hey, Kolboda is looking like a corporate giant.
Hi.
Hello. Okay. Next is Anirvan. Anirvan.
Hello.
Everything is fine. Up and running. Santanu. Santanu is doing a first aid.
Hello, Santanu.
Santanu. Hello. Hello. Everybody is high. So we are enjoying. You might want to see the highway. Wait.
Part under this is my bike, this is Santanu's bike. Dipan is wasting lot of water. See, wasting hot water, nonsense. Anirvan's bike, this is Dipan's bike. This rear view mirror went off, okay, so it got cut and it just flew off. So that's from us right now. We will catch you up ahead somewhere near Amritsar when we stop for lunch. Okay, bye bye, take care.
Seen by now that, you know, the roads are good, but again the weather was the killing factor here. So as and when we approached Punjab, we crossed Delhi, we crossed Haryana, and we decided that, you know, we would be going to Ludhiana. So we entered Punjab and the heat was soaring and we again started falling sick. So again we had to kind of wait until, you know, everybody was okay. But this time we were well prepared, as we were warned by the Delhi guys that, you know, we would be getting lot of these ups and downs in weather and temperature. So we were prepared this time. But again, how much ever preparation you take, that is not sufficient, is what we were proved to be wrong. So, but anyways, so what we decide now is that, you know, we are going to take a good proper break. And even if we start climbing the hills after entering Jammu at night also, that should be okay, because it's just about 50 kilometers from the start of the climb is what we were told by the locals here in Pathankot. So I'm expecting the journey to be smooth. It's important that we stay fit, but you know, God has something else for us. So I'm hoping to climb, as and when we climb up, the climate will, or the temperature will cool down a bit, and we will have a bit of relaxation in Pathankot. So see you in Pathankot. Bye bye.